Hello and welcome to the course Learning Linux Firewall Firewalld. In this course, you will learn how to install and configure the firewall on your system and its implication on the whole network. What is a firewall? Firewall are devices, hardware or software that protect your computer from viruses and information theft. If you are a personal user, then a software firewall suffices to protect you from external dangers that are inevitable when you connect to the internet. If your role is that of an administrator, then it is your responsibility to protect your servers, users, and data. You may choose a firewall hardware device, which, though costlier, makes more sense because it has more processing power and can check more incoming data and better protect your devices. We still continue with firewall. Firewall is a barrier from the big bad world of the internet. Consider it to be the boundary wall that protects your home, has a single point of entry, which allows only legitimate individuals to gain access to your home. Firewalld communicates to the netfilter module in the Linux kernel using the IP tables. But the Firewalld is managed using firewalld-cmd, a command line option. The netfilter, as the name suggests, empowers the Linux kernel to examine each data stream that comes or goes into a system. Netfilter is a module, a piece of code that is injected into the heart of the Linux operating system, the kernel. The firewalld divides network traffic communication into zones for a system. A case scenario usage. For example, the traffic that comes into a network from a user, say Lucy, using a smartphone at the airport and accessing her emails on company's email server encounters a different set of rules as opposed to a user who is inside your company's premises. Lucy is at the airport going to a sales conference while Jeff is at the office serving his presentation on his department's server. Both Lucy and Jeff work at the same company, but Lucy is using the internet from a public space, while Jeff's data is inside the company. So the rules for Lucy's data are stringent as compared to Jeff's. In the firewalld language, Lucy and Jeff, while working for the same company and yet are in the different zones from the security point of view. The point is not troubling your users, but problems are normal in the real world. In simple words, Lucy encounters more stringent restrictions on the company's resources while she's at the airport or any public area for that matter. A zone determines the level of trust. The level of trust for Lucy's data or data communication using the public network is much lesser than Jeff's usage of the internal network. A zone is a set of rules depending upon the levels of trust, and this management of zones is firewalld's responsibility. Different zones in firewalld. There are 9 predefined zones in the firewalld depending upon the level of trust in ascending order. However, before you understand about zones, it is important to understand the difference between outgoing and incoming traffic. The following diagram illustrates the difference. As you can see, the data originating from the computer is the outgoing traffic, while the data which is coming into the computer is the incoming traffic. To repeat the definition again, outgoing traffic, that which originates from your computer, incoming traffic, the data stream which has your computer as the destination. Now, back to different zones in firewalld. The first zone is the drop zone. This zone has the least level of trust and drops all incoming traffic without any acknowledgement to the sender, allows all outgoing traffic. Block. This zone is like the dead zone, the incoming traffic is rejected and the sender gets a message or gets an acknowledgement. Public. allows traffic from certain public networks depending upon the rules that you set. External. Here, the firewall is used as a gateway, and it represents the external interface to the world while keeping your internal network private, sort of a NAT. Internal, the set of rules that apply to the computers in your private internal network. We are still in different zones in Firewall D. DMZ, DMZ stands for Demilitarized Zone, an isolated patch of computers in your internal network that may not access other internal resources, or other people or users cannot access the computers or system in the DMZ zone. Imagine a patient kept under isolation in case of disease breakout at the hospital. Work. This zone pertains to work computers on a network, and more services are allowed. The trust level is high. Home zone. The trust level is higher than work. Most computers in this zone trust each other. The trusted zone, the highest level, the most liberal, and hence must be used with caution.